And I'm going to ask Liz Plain if she can do her presentation in 5 minutes.
Pujuani, Watia Beneshiag Desnakaz, Amjanan Gunjaba, Gayash Dodam. I'd like to acknowledge the sacred land that we walk on, the water that gives us life, the air that we breathe, and the ability for us to walk on our own individual paths. I am one of the grandmothers on the Water Women's Water Commission. I was delegated in 2008 by the regional chief. There are 5 grandmothers that sit on this commission. And last week, we were able to meet for the first time for a year and a half. Army Gwetches to Chief Day for securing some funding so that we can gather again, so that we could caucus, so that we could discuss that sacred water that we so vitally need. There were some issues that came up in our caucus that we needed to speak about to the assembly. Again, Miami Gwetches to Chief Day for hearing us. We've had a terms of reference in draft since 2007, since Chief Bokash appointed the Water Commission. We've been, and I don't know if that document has been circulated for you, Jason and Rhonda, so graciously worked on that this morning, so I don't know where that document is. We would like to continue that work and finish that draft and present it for a resolution for ratification for the fall assembly. I know right now it's too soon. But even though we've been representing the Anishinaabeg Nation, we've been meeting, we continue to do our work in our communities, we continue to liaison, we continue to advocate, we continue to be watchdogs on behalf of the water. We continue to speak on behalf of all of our brothers and sisters, our children, on documents such as the Great Lakes Water Protection. I've attended the Blue Flag Beach Program that beautifies our shores of the Lake Huron, that municipalities want to make sure that their beaches are beautiful. I remind the delegation that we have never surrendered any of our waterways or our waterbeds, that includes the beaches along the Great Lakes. We are seeking that the Anishinaabeg Nation secure more funding so that we can continue the work of the Water Commission that was delegated to us. We would also like to adopt the Chiefs of Ontario Water Declaration. There are some issues that we talked about that need probably some political backing. As you know, a Harper's bill that was received royal assent included the elimination of an environmental assessment process. Now that British Columbia has denied tar sands and those oil industries access through their province to the shores to ship that precious black oil that runs through our Mother Earth's veins. They are probably going to look for alternative routes, which is going to pass through Saskatchewan, Manitoba, Northern Ontario, down through Southern Ontario, where they can ship and port that blackened oil, our mother's veins, to other parts of the countries. Their greed for that black oil for our mother's veins is disgusting. We also need to secure that we would like to more often go into the communities and teach our children, our young women, the roles and responsibilities of caring for our water. We would like to remind our men to belay that sama down when our thunderbirds come to visit us, to remind us that those thunders are there to cleanse our Mother Earth. There's an opportunity to make lease agreements and impose our own standards should those industries decide to impose and cross Northern Ontario, because they will pass on our watersheds. They will pass on our riverways. Their greed will allow them to pass. The other environmental thing that concerns us is the fracking of the natural gases, of the air that is below this ground surface, the air that allows the shale and our grandfather rocks to breathe underground. They are extracting that. That oil or that gas is passing right through, right beside our community. And it's going to take tons and tons and tons of water to cool that gas because it is highly explosive. These are just little things that we worry about. We worry about the life of the water, the species in the water. We worry about that water that the women carry. I was reminded by my grandmother, Josephine Mandaman, last week, that as women we should always be wearing skirts so that we may draw the energy from Mother Earth, because we are the carriers of water. And that we should encourage our men to care for that fire and to care for those thunder beings. So we're going to be looking for assembly to accept our terms of reference when you gather again. And I promise I would be kind. Chief Day knows I can be very passionate. I can be very harsh at times. But Commissioner Josephine Mandaman last week posed a question to the delegation. And I will leave that question with you. What would you do if we were told we have no more water? I want to show you something. Can I borrow this? This is Nestle. They extract from Lake Superior. They extract from Lake Michigan. They are one of our biggest culprits. And one of our elders said one time, we're going to pay for water one of these days. Look at this. I urge you to boycott anything that Nestle makes. I believe they do make some Minute Maid. I believe they make Coke. Or if you're at a gathering and you're offered some water, please give one back to Mother Earth. Open one and pour it back to Mother Earth so that she can replenish. My Facebook status sometimes says, boycott plastic bottles, water. Miigwech.
Thanks, Liz.